Okay,
Okay, Divya madam.
yeah,
Yeah, we are good to go.
okay, I'll
Okay.
start now.
I request Advocate Shailendra Thatte, sir, to switch on their video so that participants can see them.
Hello, everyone, and very good morning to all. Let me extend a hearty welcome to every participant, delegate, our chief guest, our principal madam, vice principal madam, on this platform, on behalf of my co-curricular committee and college. Friends, we are all here to participate in the webinar on the topic Intellectual Property Rights, an overview for students and teachers. Now, I would take this opportunity using this occasion to briefly take all of you a little back to our rich historical heritage, where we observe and note that India over centuries has always encouraged creativity and innovation with its own system of fostering the ideas and creations. The rulers of ancient and medieval India took the intellectuals from various fields into their courts and gave them royal patronage and encouragement. From Navratnas in the court of King Vikramaditya to the court of Akbar the Great, such patronage was symbolized and was the manifestation of the importance our nation has always attached to fostering intellectual pursuits. No wonder that in modern times, we quickly grasped the modern concept of intellectual property rights and gave this concept the new meaning and well-deserved recognition and attention. Friends, we are living in the age of information revolution, and the modern concept of IPR is the result of the conversion of knowledge into commercially exploitable potential. Those economies and societies of the world which protect and promote these rights are bound to witness cultural advancement and economic progress. Hence, our universities and educational institutions are engaged in developing the expertise and providing training and teaching intellectual property rights. Teaching and training these rights are not just the issues of law stream alone, but it covers almost every stream from engineering to technology, from trade, commerce to management, applied sciences, social sciences, humanities, etc. And hence, to throw in-depth insight into this very important and highly relevant topic, we have our very renowned specialist of the area, Advocate Sri Shailen Thateji, who would be throwing the light on various dimensions on intellectual property rights. I extend a very warm, hearty welcome to you, sir, for accepting our invitation and be among us to speak on this very important topic. With these words, I would proceed next to request our principal madam, Dr. Neela Marura, to deliver the welcome address. Madam, over to you.
Marura, madam.
Hello.
Yeah, madam. Yes. Yeah, madam. I request.
I was not able to unmute.
Yeah.
Yeah. One minute. One second. I'm in contact with this.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Okay. One second. Okay. Sorry. Am I audible?
Yeah, ma'am. Yeah, ma'am.
Yes, yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, ma'am.
So, good morning to all the participants and to Mr. Shailendra Thatte and the entire co-curricular committee for organizing this seminar on IPR, Intellectual Property Right. I congratulate the co-curricular committee for organizing this very pertinent topic. As we know that creativity is boundless, and creativity is something which can be copied very fast by others who don't work at it.
So the ones who create, who make a patent, or who have any copyright or any intellectual property, which is the result of their hard work, it should not be misused by others. As we say nowadays, a lot of cut, copy, paste is happening. People are using other people's work and passing off their own. And the person who has created that intellectual property is deprived of a lot of money and credit, which is due to him. I'm sure today's webinar will throw light on what is IPR, and Ms. Advocate Shailendra, with his rich experience, will be able to share a lot of his thoughts. So I welcome you to our college program, and I welcome all the participants and look forward to listening. Thank you so much.
Thank you, ma'am, for your address. Now, before we start with the session, I would request Dr. Ashok Madit to give the detailed introduction of the speaker of the occasion to our audience. Ashok, sir.
Thank you, Divya, madam. Can you hear me?
Yeah, you are audible.
Okay. Good morning, everyone. Myself, Dr. Ashok Madit. I once again welcome all of you to this webinar, Intellectual Property Rights, an overview for students and teachers. The resource person for today's webinar is Advocate Shailendra Thatte. But before I introduce the sir, I would like to give you an idea about IPR. In this challenging time, many things have lost its importance, like face-to-face meetings, etc. And many things have gained importance, like webinars, online classes. Okay. So what is IPR? So IPR is any creation of mind. It may be a script, maybe a title of a movie, anything. It can be anything, which is a creation of someone's mind. Okay. So before I go ahead, I'll give you one example. You must have seen the movie Dhar. It was a movie made by Mr. G.P. Sippy. When he had the story was a love story, but with a new thing added, that was fear. So he wanted Dhar to be the name of this movie. So he approached for that name, but he found that someone else had already registered it. And any guesses who must have registered that? The person who used to make horror movies. Okay, let me tell you, it was Ramsey Brothers. He had already registered that name. So Mr. G.P. Sippy had to approach him and take the rights from him. And then he gave the movie name Dhar to his love story. And this is how we could see the good movie. Okay, so now coming back to introduction, it gives me immense pleasure to introduce to you our today's resource person, Advocate Shailendra Thatte. Advocate Shailendra Thatte is an eminent lawyer having a rich experience of 22 years to his credit. His field of specialization is intellectual property laws. He is also an expert in corporate commercial contracts and agreements, international technology transfer and licensing, mergers and acquisitions, legal negotiations, and IP audits. His law firm, Shailendra Thatte and Associates, caters to the need of diverse industries and has many branch offices in Maharashtra, and his headquarters is in Mumbai. His firm also is professional and has ties all over the world. They have tie-ups in Europe, US, Asia, and Africa. Advocate Shailendra Thatte is often invited as a guest speaker at several business forums, study and professional circles. He is invited by professional bodies like Institute of Chartered Accountants of India, ICAI, Institute of Company Secretaries of India, ICSI, and Information Technology Associations. His guidance in the subject of IP law is much sought after by the foreign organizations also. He has been invited to foreign countries for delivering lectures on the topic of intellectual property rights. His articles, interviews are published in various newspapers and magazines all over the world. Well, sir has provided a list of his clients, but I'll read a few only. The prominent ones are Bhabha Atomic Research Center, BARC, we all know. Serum Institute, the company who is manufacturing vaccines for us. Kesari Tours, Technocrats Security System Private Limited, ING Corporates, Australia, Thane Janta Sahakari Bank Limited, Art and Source GmbH, Germany, Bhabha Hospitality, Bhabha Group, you know all the hotels they have, Aditya Birla Retail Limited, Postim Implant Limited, Korean company, Third Eye Qualitative Research Private Limited, Nissan Enterprise Limited, Wolfman Robosch GmbH, Germany, FSH Building Group, France, and so many companies are there. So in short, we have the right person as a resource person to get knowledge about IPR. Thank you so much, Advocate Shailendra Khatri, for accepting our invitation to become the resource person for today's webinar. And now I invite you to start your sessions. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Dr. Ashok, for having a wonderful introduction of mine. Thank you. It's my pleasure to share my thoughts, my experiences with you all. It's very difficult to, interact with students offline. So online, it is very difficult, but offline, it's totally different ballgame. We can have the great interaction. We can know the body language. We can interact more on the questions which they have. But today I will try my level best to introduce the subject, the basics of intellectual property rights, okay, to all students as well as teachers. Most of the teachers must be having the knowledge of IPR as such, basics of IPR. But I will try to give some experience-wise or just sharing relating to cases as well, so that you will get a practical experience how IPR directly relates to the business world as well. So your college name is Lala Lajpat Rai College. Okay. Are we basically underestimating ourselves as a students? Most of the times it has been also discussed that we are pressurizing, the teachers or the parents are actually pressurizing their students to gain more and more knowledge. I'm of the different view altogether. At the age of 10, 15, as a student, everyone has an immense capability to understand or grasp the subject. Yes, there are certain subjects which are not of interest as such, but the subject which are interesting to them as a student, certainly they can flourish. I'm also dead against the discussions which have been done in the social media, in the newspapers. Like most of the successful businessmen are school dropouts or college dropouts. Do you think that whatever the research has happened, that is without having knowledge in the subject or without understanding the subject or without getting into the research activity? No, not at all. And therefore, your teaching, you need to have basically a good teacher, a guide to have a successful career in life. Lala Lajpat Rai actually founded his first school at the age of 20 years in Lahore. And the name of the school was Dayananda Anglo-Vedic School. Most of the teachers must be aware of that. I don't know whether the students are aware of this or not. But at the age of 20, he thought of formation of or the starting of a school, and he has done that. And still there are many branches of that school. So don't underestimate yourself at all. Yes, there are certain subjects which may not be of your interest, but concentrate on the subjects which are very useful or you think that these are interesting. I have been told that there are students who are from the commerce background. So I will try my level best to make them understand about the intellectual property from the commercial angle as well, so that they can implement it in their future life from the commerce perspective. I would like to share my PPT, Doctor. 1 minute. Yes. Can you see this? Yeah. So it's about basics of IPR today we are going to learn. So what do you mean by IPR? So it's a world of IP, okay? Everyone is always confused with the term IP. What do you mean by IP? Intellectual property. But what? It's a trademark, copyright, patent, design, geographical indications, IPR. So term IPR means intellectual property rights. What do you mean by rights? Rights on these all intellectual properties created by use of your own intellect is intellectual property right. And there are different ways to protect under different laws. That is Trademark Act, Copyright Act, Patent Act, Design Act, Geographical Indication Act. So government has drafted good acts where you can protect your intellectual property. I will tell you afterwards which are whether there is compulsion to get the registration of these intellectual property rights or not. So mainly I will talk about 4 IPs, that is trademark, copyright, patents, and designs. Most of us from the commerce background are aware of trademark and copyrights. Yes, people are aware of that patents and design, but patents and designs are related to production activity, okay, which are related to research activity. And therefore, most of the science background students are generally dealing with these patents and designs. So what do you mean by trademark? It covers the wordmark, logo. You must have seen, you take any packaging of the product, food products, eatables, anything. When you are going to McDonald's, this thing, various shops, just find out one packet and see, you will find some name on it. So that is called trademark. Clear? There is a trade name by which you are trading. That means you are doing business that is called as trade name. So, which covers your company name, logo of the company, logo of the product as well. So, for example, HLL is the company, okay? And Lux is their brand. So, here trade name is HLL. And brand name is Lux. That is a product name. Company name, again, it's a company name or company logo means it's a logo of the company as such. You may find a different logo for the different product. The companies like Pitambari or the Patanjali, okay, they have a trade name and a product name similarity. So they have their strategy there. They are not coming up with the unique names. But for most of the products, 90% of the products, they are using their trade name as a product name. But if you find out the strategy of the HLL, you will find that there are different product names which are totally different than the trade name. So packaging of the products, that is a color combination and everything, you can also protect that under intellectual property, under trademark, as well as under copyright. So I would like to take you through the process of the trademark protection as such. You know, what is required is the person who is filing the application, his address, his country, his email address, okay, which are basic things. But can you think that individual can file an application? Or every time the company or the legal entity, that is a private limited or the partnership, they have to file the or they can protect that? No. any individual can protect its intellectual property. So that is a trademark as well, okay, under Trademark Act. So tomorrow, if any one of you is planning to start a new business as an individual, as a proprietor, that is a proprietorship firm, you can start it. But before start of that, you need to find out whether someone else is using the same name or not in your category of business. So therefore, the second point is category of the mark, whether the word mark, logo, name, or trade name, that you need to decide. That is a trade name. It should be unique. So we have seen cases where most of the times, whenever the person is planning to start his business, he's more emotional, you know, about his business. So what he will generally, they are trying to, you know, use the name from his family, either the name of the mother, father, or the name of the God. But that will not serve your purpose, because anyone can use that name. For example, Ganesh, it's the name of the God. Everyone has a right to use the word Ganesh. How someone can show their exclusive right on the word Ganesh? And therefore, you need to have a unique trademark or the mark. And that's why the intellectual property rights. Okay, so write on the word which you have created or you have developed by use of your own intellect, that is trademark. So for example, prove it. So do you think that prove it, what is the meaning of prove it? No, there is no meaning at all. But the combination, what the company has done is the protein and vitamin. So combination which they have used is pro, that is a prefix of protein, and prefix of vitamin is wit. So prove it. So what law says that your mark should not be descriptive to your goods and services. Aapke naam mein se pata nahi chalna chahiye aap kya karte. Most of the times we are of the view that our mark, that is a product name, should be descriptive. Then only people will understand what is my brand. No. Then it will not become a unique mark. If you need to have uniqueness, and if you want to stop others from using your mark, then you need to have a unique name. Okay. And there are different categories in which you can protect these trademarks. So there are different 45 categories, you know. So like the cosmetics, pharmaceuticals. I will give you an example. Say, for example, there is a spa. So spa category services falls under class 44. If tomorrow my spa services are, say, taking my business to the next level and I have, say, 7 to 8 spa centers in Mumbai. So can I do business of cosmetics as well in that particular, with that particular brand? No, because I have protected my mark in the spa services and not for cosmetics. But is it you can link that cosmetics to spa? Yes. Through spa, I can sell my cosmetics products as well. So what is important, you need to visualize whether I can diversify my business into related categories of products or not. Why I'm saying all this? Because you're all commerce students and you have that commercial angle. Or tomorrow you are planning to start your own business, or you are planning to advise other people who are in the business. So you need to know what is intellectual property rights and how they are related to businesses. So my whole idea is giving the details of this is to make you understand how commercially you can exploit intellectual property rights. We have seen cases that Indians are not on the path of commercialization of intellectual property. Yes, we are developing our intellectual property, but cannot commercialize it. So the reference which I'm giving, that if I am running a spa, whether I can sell my cosmetic products through spa or not. And if yes, can I protect that brand in cosmetics too? Then you have to. Okay. I will just go to examples. So, do you think that there is a similarity of the these two logos? Yes. Any common person will get be confused because of these two labels or logos. These are two different companies, okay, which have developed these logos. Dettol, everyone is aware of Dettol, okay, but just see how the company, which is another company, okay, which is a competitor of Dettol, has used Dettol. So on the face of it, it is very confusing, and in our legal term, it is very similar to the existing brand as such. So Dettol has created its goodwill in the market. So the case was Dettol versus Dettol, and Dettol wins this trademark infringement suit, and High Court imposes 1 lakh cost on Dettol for using the similar brand. So whenever you are planning to launch a brand, when you are planning to have a business, you need to create your own brand. Never copy any brand, or never try to use the artistic work of any other company as such. BMW, DMW. Again, people are trying to use the similar marks and to confuse their customers and to get business out of BMW. In this case also, Delhi High Court stated that it's a similar mark. And what BMW actually tried to show that they are into rickshaw business, so they can differentiate from the car and rickshaw. Okay, but at the same time, yes, common person will get confused, and there is a big risk to the goodwill which BMW has created. Louis Vuitton versus Louis Vuitton Duck. Okay, again, it's a case of trademark, where the similarity of the logo which has been used in both the products, if you can see. On the left-hand side, if you can see, which is a bag has a chocolate color, okay? The artistic work which has been used on that purse is similar with the, on the right-hand side, black one. So black one has copied the design of the chocolate purse. I will not go into more details about that. I will try to explain you at a very basic level. So about trademark, I would also like to tell you or to share the practical experiences of, say, Kesari. We'll take an example of Kesari tools which we have handled. Okay. Kesari is in the business of travel industry, and which has been declared by the Mumbai High Court as a well-known brand. What do you mean by well-known brand? No one can use the word Kesari in any of the fields, not in travel, but in cosmetics, in spa, in none of the industries now one can use the word Kesari. Why this has happened? They have created goodwill. They are in the different types of businesses. They are in the construction business. And there is a one person from Delhi who has started a website with the name Kesari. There are many customers of Kesari who thought of that there is a Delhi company which is actually the subsidiary of the Kesari, Mumbai, and they have paid huge amount of money for their foreign travels. And these customers has filed a complaint at the next level of communication, stating that we have paid the money to you, but we have not received itinerary from your side. Why this has happened? So our client has said, we haven't received any booking from you. We haven't received any money from you. When we integrated, so we found out that these customers of Kesari has paid money to Delhi company, okay, which are planning, which is from develop a website with the name Kesari and tried to confuse general public and thereby got money and therefore cheating people. So we filed a case in Mumbai High Court, and we claim that this is a brand which is trying to use our goodwill and trying to confuse the customers and trying to cheat as well. So So court has ordered that Delhi company has to pay 5 lakhs of rupees as a penalty. So here, we have to be very careful while we are using, when we are developing the website. Most of the students, I have seen where college-going students are trying to sell some products online without knowing the importance of the law. Where we have found that some other companies are filing cases against students. So what I'm saying, don't run, behind money to sell products online for some money, some out-of-pocket expenses to get. Don't do that. Concentrate on your studies. Find out how you can develop your own intellectual property. Yes, and how you can commercialize at the next level after your studies. That is more important. I will try to go to the next topic, copyright. I request all students to note down whatever the questions which you have regarding to trademark. We will cover all this after this session. Certainly would like to answer. Now, copyright, this is very interesting. Most of us are aware what is copyright. So any literally dramatic, musical, artistic, architectural softwares, for that matter, falls under the category of copyright. So what do you mean by literally? Literally means anything which is written, you can copyright. I would like to highlight over here, just like trademark, which I have explained, that is need not be, it is not compulsory to get it registered. The same way copyright need not be get it registered compulsorily. But I would like to share one case, since it is related to the teachers as well as students. There is one chartered accountant in Mumbai from Malad who is basically still, he's doing business of teaching and everything. He was a professor and he was trying to teach in specific style. The full year, one student from his batch copied everything, the style in which he has taught, filed an application with the copyright office Delhi, okay, stating that it is his copyright on the study material. He joined hands with another teaching class. That particular class has started selling that particular copyrighted material in the market. So this is clear-cut cheating case, where the student has tried to use the copyright material or the teaching material and tried to get some commercial benefit out of this, which has been actually developed by that professor. So here, teachers, you have to keep in mind that whatever, if you are having a specific style of teaching or the study material, if as such, you need to protect that, though it is not compulsory, so that you can show your right on the same. And though it has not been registered, still you can take action against anyone who is trying to use the content of the teaching material without your permission. So Copyright Act is very strict. Under Copyright Act, you can take criminal action where the person who is infringing your copyrights can go behind bars. So there are good provisions under the Act. Only thing is that one has to take legal action and one has to enforce the law. So this was a very interesting case from the teaching perspective. Literally work, as Dr. Ashok said, relating to film industry. So we have done copyright for the Sarkar feature film when the Sarkar won. And then Sarkar 2 was launched by Ram Gopal Varma. But Parag Sanghvi, that is a K. Sera Sera Productions, got all copyrights in the Sarkar 1. Okay. And on the basis of copyright registration, he stopped Ram Gopal Varma from using the copyrights of Sarkar 1. And then they both jointly launched Sarkar 2. So what is critical, you need to have copyrights, registrations as well, whatever you are developing. So in the feature film, the script is very critical. You need to protect that. So if you are writing something and if you are a good writer, then if it is difficult for you to get the copyrights registration, at least you have to send an email to yourself to take it on the record that on so and so date you have created this material. Otherwise, if you are writing something on in your book, it is very difficult to prove, say after 2 years, that you have created this material. No, that is not possible. So though you are not getting, you know, things published in the general public as such, send an email to yourself, create the evidence so that tomorrow you can take action against someone who is trying to use your copyright material. Dramatic material are dramatic copyrights. Again, it's related to drama. Live performances can be copyrighted. Musical, again, musical things, I don't know, most of the student must be having some good knowledge about music. Some must be, you know, writing or some poems or songs. Some must be giving or developing compositions for that matter. And some must be having their own recording as well. So there are three types of copyrights in musical things. One in the literary work, in songs or poem. Second in the composition, that is the way in which the music will be played. And the third, the sound recording, the way it has been recorded. So sound recording will get a separate copyright. So there are three types of copyrights. So for example, if I have written one song, okay, I have my copyright. I can give that copyright to X person to have or to give composition or develop composition on that. That person can do further commercialization by way of sound recording. But I have only given the rights for the composition, but original rights are with me. I have licensed it to him. So there is a difference between sale and license. I have licensed my literary work to X person. So I will have my other rights for exploitation with another person as well. So I will give the same poem to another person, okay, for developing another composition. So you need to understand for the development of such rights that if you want to sell, then the assignment or sale can be used. But if you can give it on the license, you have every right to exploit to the next level. Artistic work. Anything relating to art can be copyrighted. Architecture work, yes. The graphs and everything, if you have developed by yourself, you can get a copyright for that. I would like to share one or two examples relating to copyrights in photographs. There is an interesting case which has settled in the UK. Renowned photographer was a wild photography passion, and he installed one camera in the jungle. And after 2 days, he again visited jungle and got that camera back. And he got to know there are good selfies of monkey. Okay, so monkey has done? He came in the front of the camera. He was not aware what is that. He has clicked something and a photo generated. Okay. So now in this, who is the owner of the copyright? That is the issue. Photographer has developed those photographs, commercialized it very well, earn good amount of money. Okay. Animal lover organization or NGO from UK has filed a case against the photographer, stating that photographer has just installed the camera in the jungle. Who has taken the photograph? Monkey has taken the photograph. Oh, maybe it's a selfie in today's world. Okay, but the photograph has taken by that monkey. That means all copyrights is in the name of monkey. So what is important? The person who takes the photograph has the right on the same. So in all copyrights, author is more important. And there has to be, say, for example, if any company, Okay, he's appointing some another employee and asking him to take the photograph. In that case, there is an arrangement between company and a photographer that it is on hire and therefore all the rights will come back to the company. But at the first instant, the person who is clicking the photograph has a right on the same. And therefore, it is a very interesting case to have a fantastic example. The person who takes the photograph has a right on the same. So that means author. So any author has a right in the intellectual property. So the UK court has given the judgment in the favor of that NGO and said that whatever the amount that photographer has earned, he has to give some portion of that to this NGO who will spend some money in the interest of that. So that was a fantastic judgment of the photographer. Another photographer example, one photograph has been taken by one photographer, well-known personality. And after his death, another company, again, it's a well-known company, has given an advertisement in the good newspaper stating that, and they printed that photograph and mentioned that in the remembrance of so-and-so after the death of that well-known personality. So that personality's legal heirs file a case against that company who has given that advertisement, though the advertisement was with the tagline that in the remembrance of so and so. Company has not any right to publish the photograph without the permission of that person or the person who has taken the photograph or the legal heirs after this. So what is critical here is, again, the judgment was in the favor of the legal heirs, of those legal heirs. Okay. So again, what is important is the author. That photographer has taken the photograph, but without the permission of that person, he cannot give it to any other person. There are, you know, very common things like Taj Mahal or any monuments, okay, which is available to you. You can take the photograph. Certainly, it is open. You can have a drawing of the Taj Mahal or any fort for that matter. You will have right on that particular photograph, or you will have the right in that artwork. Okay, but that does not mean that no other person can the photograph of that monument. No, anyone can take that. But the way in which it has been taken or developed has the right of the photograph. So again, it's an interesting case. So again, these are the very things which are directly related to Act. I will not go into details of that. I will go to the patents law now. So what do you mean by patents again? Patent is generally related to the science or those people who are dealing with the production as such. So what law says, it should be related to industrial product. So there is always confusion what is patent. So most of the times, businessmen as well, you know, trying to convince me, no, I have the patent in this, some of the products, when he is actually planning to say he want to protect the under trademark. So people are still not aware what is trademark, copyright, patent, designs. So here I would like to bifurcate. Patent means always related to industrial product. Nothing to do with any other product. Nothing to do with any other services as such. If anything relating to service, it will fall under either copyright or the trademark. But it will not fall under the category of the patents or designs. That is a major difference. Again, trademark and copyright, one can get the registration. There is no compulsion at all. But for patents and designs, it is very much important to file an application with the patent office or design office so that you can get the right. If you fail to file an application and then launch the particular product, then you are losing your right on the same. First, you have to file the application, then only you can take into the market. Because what law says that it should be unique. It should not be generic as such. It should not come in the public domain before filing of the application. Once it is in the public domain, anyone can use it. You cannot take action against who is planning to copy your patent or the product as such. and therefore it is necessary to file an application for the patent. Most of the manufacturing or the businessmen are, you know, not aware of this particular provision, and they don't want to spend money on the protection, but they are spending money in the research activities. Since the crowd is the students here who are from the commerce background, I will not go into the details of the research as such. But for the patents, what is important is the research. So before developing any product, every student who is doing research, he has to go into details of the prior art search. So which are the technologies which are available in the market, which are already published? There is a patent data search is also available. Okay, where you can go into details of the patent and find out on which category of or the activity the patent has been granted. So you cannot go into details of that again to have the right. Most of the times we have seen that, you know, students are doing research more and more, spending their time, say 2 years or 3 years. But after that, they are doing the further research on the patent side. And in that case, they generally find out, yes, there is another patent which are already granted. In that case, they are wasting their whole period of, say, 2 or 3 years in the research they are, you know, putting in. Most of the colleges are also having tie-ups with the students. So like IIT, or most of the IITs are after graduation from the science. Now IITs are having tie-ups with the businessmen. So businessmen are asking the colleges that we are ready to give funds to you for the research. And science students and teachers are doing research on them. And institutes like IIT are having no proper agreement with the businessmen for development of that research. So there is a commercial activity can be initiated by the college as well, where the intellectual property rights will be owned by the college and the businessmen jointly and commercialized jointly, in which case the student, if the pass out, if he's already graduated, certainly he will get right in that, or his name has to be there as an inventor. So there is a difference. I will tell you about the difference. So the primary thing what I have said is the novelty. It has to be novel. Inventive step has to be there. And industrial application has to be there. I will give a simple example of the patent. Just imagine that there is a telephone machine. Okay. And there is no redial function in the telephone machine. Just assume that. And if you have developed that redial function in that telephone machine, then you will have right on the redial function only and not on the telephone as a whole. Because what you are developing is the upgradation of the technology relating to redial function. So then how you can commercialize? Either you can manufacture your own telephone having a redial function, or you can sell that redial function to existing manufacturers of telephone machine, or you can license it to them. So there are different ways of commercialization. I will let you know better. So again, the applicant and the inventor may be different in this. But in the patent, inventor has to be the individual. Inventor cannot be the legal entity, because patent can be developed by the individual who is a living person who has a brain to develop. So private company cannot show its own name, or partnership firm cannot show its own name as an inventor. There has to be individual name has to be given. Most of the times we have seen that businessmen are there giving their own name as an inventor, which is the biggest mistake. Students who are there, who are in the research, they must ask if they are planning to join the company, if they are developing something new, then their name should be there as an inventor. And the applicant will be the company. Okay, but you also have to keep in mind that there is a understanding and what you call as an employee agreement between the company and the employee. So the students, you must understand that those legal terms matters a lot. Mahindra and Mahindra has filed a case against its employees who has tried to resign from the company and then filed a patent application in his own name when he has developed that patent during his employment. So whatever you are developing during your employment in future will be the property, intellectual property of that company, because on the basis of their support you are developing. So there are title of invention. Again, most important point is that all intellectual properties are nationwide. So tomorrow, if you are exporting any product out of India, you need to protect your intellectual property in that country. If you are not doing so, you are losing your right in that country. Recently, I would like to share one example. There was a technology transfer happening between two companies, from Israel company and India company. So the deal was for 7 crores of rupees. Okay. Israel company has quoted that, mentioned that the technology, we have the patents in Europe, in US, in Israel. So the terms which they have used in the initial discussion, that we have the intellectual property all over world. But when we have done the further research, we found that Israel company have not filed any patent in India. And if they have not filed a patent in India, then in India, anyone can copy that technology and Israel company cannot stop us from using the same technology. So we have to be very careful. If we are developing something, then you need to protect that patent or designs or any intellectual property in your own country. And if you are planning to exploit the rights out of that, say in UK or in Germany, you need to file application in UK or Germany within 30 or 31 months from the date of your filing of first application in India. Just imagine if you are not filing that application in Europe, then you are losing your right of commercialization there. So anyone can copy. The same way anyone can copy in India if US company has not filed patent application in India. So there are companies who are appointing research activists or the people like us to find out the technology company who have not filed application in India so that they can copy. So this is also happening. It's difficult to use the technology as such, because there are different parameters involved in that, but at least they will get some knowledge out of that. The term of the patent, I would like to highlight over there, why there is a term of 20 years for the patent. So the logic behind having a limited term of 20 years, that research should go on and there must be development in each technology. Therefore, the provision has been made for a limited period of 20 years in patents, where you can exploit that rights in 20 years and then it will come in the public domain, so that anyone can have further research in that particular technology and have the further patent in that technology. So the prior art search I have mentioned, first you need to conduct a search and then go ahead with the patent. Infringement analysis, whether someone can infringe my patent or not. Provisional application, again, what is provisional application? Say, when I am in the research stage, that is the initial stage of development, okay? If you have not developed a research, full research, you have to file a provisional application so that you can protect your rights from today. And if someone is coming with the same technology, say after tomorrow, you can stop him from doing the same research or developing the same product. So what is critical is the provisional application. Foreign country strategy, I have just mentioned commercialization. Again, why joint venture, that is commercialization by joint venture, is necessary. So you all are commerce graduate or studying commerce. Okay. What is important is you need to develop the strategy of commercialization as well. If my client you know, it doesn't have money to protect the intellectual property in UK, then I will ask him to have a joint venture in UK. Find out one person from UK who will invest in your patent so that you can have the joint ownership of the intellectual property in UK with him. And you can both commercialize in that particular country. But don't think that if I'm not having money, I will not go there. I will not invest money. Give a different route to that. Have a joint venture. Most of the times we have something in our, no, I will not do joint ventures because I have developed this technology. Please do not do that. Do not keep any ego in any commercial activity at all. I will come to the design part. Just a short of time I have, last 10 minutes if I'm not wrong. So design. Design of any product. What do you mean by design? That means the only feature of shape, configuration, pattern, ornament, or composition of lines or color applied on any article. So this is a glass. On this particular glass, there is a particular design. If I have manufactured this glass or if I have developed this particular glass, then for this particular design, I have to file an application for how it looks. If I file application before launch of the product, I have every right to stop anyone from using the same design in the glass manufacture. So if you see any product, so Bisleri bottle, if the Bisleri has protected that design under its own name, another water manufacturer cannot use the same bottle design. Coca-Cola, I will give an example afterwards, the specific way in which it has been manufactured, the bottle. Okay, so you can show your right on the design of the product. Again, difference between design and patent. In patent, it is relating to technology, manufacturing process. And in design, it is relating to the shape and configuration. It is nothing to do with the technology at all. It is purely shape and configuration. That's it. How to manufacture, nothing to do. It's all how it looks. That's it. Again, it's a 10 years and can be extended by 5 years. Again, it is whether it is compulsory to file an application. It is not compulsory, but without filing, it is not be in your interest. Anyone can copy and use the same if you are not filing the application. So this is a specific way in which the bottles have been manufactured with specific design. No one can use this design for any type of, for use of any bottle, not only for cold drinks. I will not use the same bottle for the water as well. So it is a design relating to the bottle as used for any purpose. Again, this is a very unique case. The tablet has been designed in a specific style, D-shaped tablet, which is very unique and for which the design has been granted. On the tablet also, there is one design. So it's all about industrial, again, design in respect of industrial product. Design on the packaging of the product is called as copyright. That design is totally different. Design means design relating to industrial product. The packaging of the product design is called artistic work, or you can call it as a copyright of that particular artistic work. So that is a major difference. People, most of the people get confused. They design on the packaging of the product. No, design of the packaging will go under copyright. In that, you can protect the color combinations as well. But in design, you cannot protect the color combinations. Only how it looks, that's it, without color. So there are no rights in the color under design. I will show some more examples of the design. So there is a very small difference between these two bottles, first two bottles of Plintim, Puro bottle and Kudos bottle. You know, if you can see the purple this thing color, both bottles have used, they have, you know, color combination, they have used perfectly. There is a common person will certainly will get confused because of this. Only on the right hand side bottle top, there is a different design. And the right hand side bottle in the middle, there is a different design. The same way you can see Puro bottle packaging as well. So packaging also, they have used the same thing. Again, it's very interesting here where it has been, the matter has been discussed on the basis of the wave design. Okay, plaintiff's product, that is Irish Smart, it has been used in specific style, which is called a wave pattern. Defendant has also tried to use the same, and both are in the same category of business. So certainly person will get confused, or the customer will get confused because of use of such design. In the defendant case, they have, you know, used a different color as such. But again, in Design Act, there is no question of color, the way it has been reflected. I purposefully inserted this particular slide because you all are common students about the commercialization of intellectual property. And most of the Indians are not aware how to commercialize. They are very emotional about their business. They will never think I can license my product to someone, whether I can give it on the franchise, whether I have the valuation or not. We have seen the cases that is of the transmission. Most of the cases we have seen that due to fear, people are registering their intellectual properties in their own name, that is personal name. Okay. But what will happen in the death case? We have, yes, there is a way you can protect, that is under a will, while drafting a will. 99% of the cases where the drafting of the will, businessmen are not taking into consideration the intellectual property as well. We all only considering property. That is my bungalow, my flat, my car, my land. But no one is thinking of intellectual property while drafting the will. So when I'm drafting my will, I need to take into consideration the intellectual properties, whether the script of this movie, whether the script of the drama, whether any artwork which I have developed, whether I have developed any patent or design. Then I need to include that in the will if I want to protect that in my individual capacity. We have done some IP audit of, say, 400 crore brand, which is in India. Okay. The same case, individual name registration, but not reflected in the will. So we change the will of that particular businessman to giving effects that if he dies after his death, who will own this intellectual property as well. So sale means direct sale. I can sell my brand to anyone. I can license the brand to anyone. License means I'm just like flat. When I'm giving my flat to someone on the license, on the rental, I can give my brand to someone on the license. I will get a royalty yearly and I will enjoy that royalty. In the franchise model, I will have the ownership of that. Okay? So in the franchise model, I will have the ownership. I will give it on the license as well. And I will dictate the terms. McDonald's, as a franchisee model, the trust which is running this model, they are giving these franchises to various people on their own terms, whereas the brand is still owned by the trust. And they are commercializing by way of franchise. In the franchisee, you can also say that how the business will get run, okay, and how you can earn money out of it, and out of that, how much percentage you will get. Percentage of the business, percentage of the sale. But in the license, it's just a pure license. I will get a monthly fee. That's it. Valuation. Or the valuation directly relate to securitization. Intellectual property, just like other properties, you can give it or place it with the bank. SIDB is giving loan on the basis of the intellectual property. Software, nowadays IT is the big thing. Everyone, for any business, for anything, right now what we are doing is by use of the software. So who will own this particular software? And if I want to develop a further software, I want to do the further research on my software, but I don't have the money right now, I can give my existing source code with the bank. I will ask the bank that I have created this particular source code. So and so users are using that. I need further money to develop this. I need a loan on that. So I will mortgage. I will give this particular software that is a source code or the intellectual property to the bank, and I will get a money from that as a loan. Recently, we have done from the company from Pune. He got a loan of 5 crores by pledging or by giving on the mortgage basis of their own software. They have multiple software, 10, 15 softwares. I'm not saying on the one software they got 5 crores, but the multiple software. The biggest example is Kingfisher. Though there was a link of, you know, bank and everything, that is a different story. But the brand, on the basis, on the goodwill they created, the bank has given loan to Kingfisher on the valuation purpose. 2,000 crores were given on that time. For businessmen, it is a heart. Intellectual property is the heart of your business. And if no one is taking care of that, businessman will face heart attacks in his business. So it is directly related to business. Though since you, somewhere you all are having a direct connect with the companies, whether it's employment or you are planning to start your own business, whatever it is, it is directly connected. You are going to advise someone tomorrow. So you should be aware that what is the importance of intellectual property. Just imagine you have developer, you are the advisor or the working as a chartered accountant or working as a company secretary, tomorrow working you are as a lawyer in the firm or the with the company. And if the IP is not protected, and if tomorrow if there is a case and you have to change the name from that, what will happen? So first thing is the intellectual property. I have seen cases where the IIM students who are starting their own business at the initial stage, they are not taking care of intellectual property. It's good to see that the college like yours are taking initiative to discuss such topics with the students. I'm very happy. I will tell about the IP audits. Again, it's a regular check which we have to do. Now I would like to highlight the point about the agreements. Okay, you must be having the law like Contract Act and other acts in the commerce. You name an agreement, you will file an intellectual property in that. You name it. Partnership deed. 99% of the partnership deeds I have seen, there is no mentioning of intellectual property, unfortunately. You need to understand if there is a partnership firm, okay, and there are two partners who are running the business, and if there is a dispute tomorrow, say after 6 years, who will own that trade name? Who will own that intellectual property which partnership firm has developed till date? It has been mentioned that if there is a resignation or there is a dispute, the firm will get closed. Okay, but after dissolution of the firm, both the partners are separate, and if both the partners are trying to use the same name in the market, customers will get confused because of that. So there has to be provision in the partnership deed that in case of dissolution of the firm, who will own the intellectual property? Manufacturing agreements, service agreements, franchise agreements. Now I will tell you just here, I will discuss about the social media as well. Each one of us directly or indirectly related to the social media. What is happening in the social media? We are doing copy pasting most of the times. Are we doing our proper research while doing so? Are we infringing the copyrights of some other people who are writing the blogs? Or we are just copying and just pasting it? my request is to you, whenever you are doing the copy pasting, at least give credit to the person who is writing that blog. You should make a habit of that. Otherwise, you are disrespecting the person who is writing the blog. So in the social media, you can use that, but give the credit to someone who is actually taking efforts on that. Employee-employee agreements, partnership deed, joint ventures, everything. Media. So I think I tried to cover most of the things. In the meantime, I would like to discuss one or two. I think I have 4 minutes. I will discuss one case, okay, where the one client from India, who is a manufacturer of, I will not take the name, manufacturer of the shooting jackets and everything, whose products have been used by 70% of Olympic sportsmen. Okay, he faced a problem in Europe, okay, about his trademark, the brand by which he is selling his products. He has an international presence. He has protected his brands in India. But he, with his trust, he relied on someone else in Europe, had discussion with him for the joint venture, gone ahead with the distribution. And that particular gentleman from Germany has filed application for that particular brand and registered the brand in Germany. And now after 2 years, he's blackmailed saying that the brand is in my name. You cannot do business in Europe. So we have filed a case against him and that got brand back to us that is there. But what is important, what I mentioned that the international brand, if you're exporting any brand out of India, you need to protect it internationally as well. I would like to take an example of the software, last example. If you are developing any software in any company, okay, keep it in mind that though you are developing a software, you will be considered as author, but you cannot use the source code for anything which is not related to you, maybe after leaving the company as well. After the leaving company as well, if you are using the same source code, then that company can file a criminal action against you. We have done this for 2 or 3 companies, software companies, where the employees have tried to use the software and use the source code for development of their own business. Lastly, what I will say that you need to have proper research before development of any activity. Intellectual property is directly related, whether it's a commerce or whether science or the art or the any stream as such. And you have to be very careful and at the time of the commercialization of the intellectual property. My point is that if you are though not developing your intellectual property of your own, don't disrespect others. Give credits to the people who are using, or if you are using their intellectual property, and in your personal or in future business. That's it. Thank you, everyone. Dr. Ashok, over to you. I would like to take any questions if any of the students or the teachers have, certainly.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Sure. Participants, I'll just grant you permission to unmute yourself. If you have any queries, please unmute yourself and ask your questions. Otherwise, you can put it in chat box also if you have any queries, any doubts.
In the meantime, I would like to, again, why I'm sharing examples, you know. So through examples, you will come to know the subject very well. I purposefully tried to not to use basically jargons, legal jargons in that. Then it is very difficult to understand what is the meaning of that, how it is related to the subject as such. So which you will certainly study in your regular day-to-day, you know, learning thing. In the, I will like to share one example, okay, if I we have time, okay.
Yes, sure, sir.
Yeah, so there was a shoe manufacturer from Mumbai, okay? And he has given the work of designing the shoe to another agency who is into development of designs. Okay. So actually there were around 20 or 30 people working in that agency. One of the employee has developed the design and given it to the our client. And they have gone through the design. They liked it. There was a exhibition in Italy. Okay. And after, I think, 1 month, they have exhibited that particular shoe product in the exhibition in Italy. You know, after 2 days, so there were, I think, 5 days exhibition was there. After 2 days of the exhibition, another person, manufacturer from Italy, visited the shop, visited the stall of this our client and said that this is the exact design which we have. And we have the design rights in Italy. What you have exhibited in Italy, that is totally wrong. And you have to pay so and so money to us. So now in this case, who is at fault? Okay, whether our client is at fault, the company who has exhibited the product, or the company agency who has developed the design. So for Italy manufacturer, Indian company is at fault, certainly, because they are directly exhibited the product. Then what we have done, we have done reverse exercise, and we found that the person who has designed, or what he has said that I have designed, actually he has copied the design from X website and given it to the client. So on the basis of that, client relied on that, and he has exhibited the product. So what is important that whenever you are designing or giving the work to someone else, you have to be very sure what he is designing is original one. And you have to take indemnity from him who is designing, that is the author, stating that all my material, what we are designing is original. And if there is any case, we will indemnify from you from any of the losses as such. So that is very critical. This was another very interesting case. How you had to take care while giving work to someone for the development of the intellectual property. And if you are acting as a developer or the artistic, creator of that, never do copy of anything from website or any other sources. Try to create your own things.
Yes, definitely. Okay, sir, I wanted to ask one thing. Can we have arrangement wherein we can register with all the countries at a time? Is there any organization who can do that?
Yes. There is a Madrid protocol. Okay. There are for patents, that is a PCT route, patent cooperation treaty is there, where you can file one application through Indian Patent Office and select the countries in which you want to file a patent. And you need to select a country office as well. So for example, if I'm selecting Australia, so Australian Patent Office will conduct the international search for that particular patent and send the search results to us. And then we have to act accordingly. So, but yes, there is a patent cooperation treaty where you can file a patent through Indian Patent Office to various countries. The same way, under Madrid Protocol, you can file a trademark application, okay, in various countries, okay, where you can file one application through Indian Trademark Office and file in other countries. But there is a threat as well. If your trademark is registered in India, okay, then it is advisable to use such treaties where you can file at one go in various countries. But if your mark is not registered and then you are filing, and say tomorrow, if trademark registry is not giving you that particular registration, then all applications which you have filed in other countries will get rejected. So what is critical is to have the, IP protection in India first, and then proceed with the these treaties.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
But for patent, you can directly go with filing of the initial application, original application, maybe in India.
That was useful. Okay. Darshan sir, which slide you want him to share? Sir, if you could share a few slides at the beginning, we had shown few charts. Huh? So I want to have a look at it.
I have to? You are asking me?
Yes, yes, sir. Shailendra sir, please share a few files.
Which slide?
Wait, huh?
Relating to which subject? Trademark, copyright, patent, design?
Trademark. Yes.
This one?
Yeah. Yes, keep this. Okay. Darshan sir, have you taken the photographs? Okay. Diva madam, are you there?
Sir, we can start now. Question and answer session, please.
Yes, yes. I think participants don't have any questions. I asked one question. Participants, please feel free. If you have any query, you can ask questions.
Ashok sir, I do have one more question.
Yes, please go ahead.
Sir.
Yeah.
Sir, suppose we develop some one particular type of yeast for a wine or some formulary. So that can be patented?
The process. There are again two things. The process patent and the product patent. The way in which it has been developed, that is a process. Yes, you can get a patent for that.
Yes, in India,
so
we...
before doing that, it is advisable to go into details of the similar patents which has been already published. So for example, there are different types of wines which are already available. If just you are using or changing the percentage of the combinations of various ingredients, then we cannot say that there is a patent. So for example, I will just give you an example of the engineering product. Say if you are using any technology in gas sector, okay, and if you are planning to use the similar technology or the same technology as one of the parameters in water field, okay, we cannot get a patent for that, because what we are doing, we are trying to use the same technology, but for the different industry. That will not serve our purpose, because what loss is, which is already existing in the market or which is already in the public domain as such, one cannot get a patent over it. But yes, if we can prove that you have a different process of manufacturing all together with the different ingredients as such, different molecules for the pharmaceutical as such, certainly you will get a patent for that. But such type of productions, there has to be study and a certificate from the lab as well about the process manufacturing and its results as such.
Okay, sir. Thank you. I did it here.
Okay, question, sir. Anyone else who would like to ask any question? You can unmute yourself or put your question in chat box. Okay, there is one message. I'll read it. Sir, patent laws are universal, or each country has its own laws?
Patent law is related to each and every country separately, and we have to follow the law of that country as such. But most of the countries are party to the PCT route treaty. So PCT treaty, patent cooperative treaty. And most of the laws are similar as such in respect of the patent. As I said, what is important is that before within 30 or 31 months, some countries 30, some countries 31 months, we need to file an application in that country from the date of first filing application in India. And if we are not filing that within 30 months, any person from that country can copy that, or XYZ country can copy that, and we cannot stop them from using the same technology. So there is nothing like universal patent as such. It's a country-wise only. Yes, there are certain countries which are, groups of countries, like European Union is there. So we can file a one patent application or one trademark application in that particular union and get the protection for whole of the Europe as such. Like the African countries, there is a ARIPA is there, which is some 27 countries which are part from the Africa. Okay, where you can file a patent application or the trademark application and get the registration for those 27 countries. So it depends on the union or the groups of such countries or regions.
So,
yes. You're mute, Dr. Ashok.
Sir, you are on mute, sir.
If any other participant would like to ask any question, please go ahead.
My request to all the students is that whenever you are going to any shop, purchasing anything, any product, you will find two things. One, trademark, that is a product name. And another is copyright. Copyright means packaging of the product. There is a Parle G biscuit, okay, which is commonly used by everyone. Or Oreo biscuit, which has been used by many children. Okay, you will find there is a brand called Oreo. Okay, there is a design on the biscuit, which will fall under the Design Act. And there is a packaging of the product, which will fall under the copyright. So make a habit to analyze the live example in your daily life, which will help you to understand the subject very well. If you can have any further questions on that, after going through all these observations, maybe after 10 days or 15 days or 1 month, you can pass on to Dr. Roshit Madik, certainly, and I will be happy to answer that after yourself.
You can definitely share your email ID also if you want. So there are teachers from other colleges also.
Oh, okay.
They will contact you for webinars and all.
My pleasure.
Yes. Okay, one more question is there. Let me read the question. Can the copyright breach case be filed by anyone, or it has to be by the owner himself?
Pardon, can I come again? Sorry.
If there is infringement of any copyright, who can file the case? Can third party can file the case, or that owner has to file the case?
In this case, owner has to file the case. Third party can intervene if he is have the party to that particular transaction. But unless and until you are the party, you cannot. Yes, there are certain public interest litigations where you are party, so that you are actually what I can say is that if I will give an example of basics of word mark or the trademark. What law says that your mark should not be descriptive in nature. The best example is that Apple. Okay, Apple is generic to the industry of softwares or computers. No. But Apple is generic to the common world. Or there is a dictionary meaning, that is the name of the fruit as such. So therefore, but Apple is not generic to the software industry, and therefore it becomes a unique mark. But just take an example, there are two fruit sellers. One is using Apple Enterprises, and another is using Apple Fruits or Apple Goods, something else, okay? No one can stop each other, because their main business is to sell apples or to sell fruits. So what is most important is that you should not use the generic names which are in the field commonly used. For example, pyramids. Okay, in Vastu Shastra, pyramid word is commonly used. And if you are trying to register the right on the word pyramid, then as a third party, I can file a case and I can challenge the registration which you got, stating that pyramid is a generic word. Everyone has a right to use the word pyramid in Vastu Shastra, and you cannot have the registration on that. So in the act, there is a provision where you can challenge the registration itself. If government has given the any registration wrongly, as a third party, you have every right to challenge that on the basis of the parameters given in the act. Yes, it is not in the public interest. No one can show the right on the generic words used in the industry as such. On those parameters, as a third party, you can challenge that. I will share one case where the one person, Nanubhai Jhaveri, was there, the Gujarati person from Goregaon in the manufacturing sector. And 30 years he has used the word Larsen. Larsen Engineers was, he was dealing that. So while using Larsen Engineers, many times he has done work for Larsen and Toubro as well. But one day at the age of 70, someone has said that, why you are not going for the trademark registration? You can sell it to someone. So he filed the application with the trademark registry for Larsen Engineers. And trademark registry has advertised the mark. After advertisement, within 4 months, anyone can take a file and objection. So that Larsen and Toubro has seen, their lawyers have seen, and they have filed an objection stating that the Larsen is the name which is similar to Larsen and Toubro. And they have filed a case in the High Court, Mumbai. And the court has said, Nanubhai Jhaveri has not appeared for the first hearing. And court has said, you cannot use the word Larsen till the next hearing since you have not appeared. And your accounts have been freezed from today. So he must be having some lakhs of rupees at the age of 70 in the name Larsen Engineers, since he was doing the business at the age of 70 as well. But account has been freezed. Then he approaches, the court has freezed the accounts, what we can do? Our first question was, why you have selected the name Larsen for your business? Being a Gujarati, there is no question of having the name Larsen in his family. None of his daughter, there was no daughter. And if a daughter has said, you know, married to any Catholic person, there is no question of having Catholic person with the relation. No. Then what is the objective of the use of the word Larsen? There was no objective. So when you are giving any name or using a name, there has to be clarification to be given why you have used this name. So if my name is Shailendra, I have every right to use the word Shailendra. No one can stop me from using my own name. Like that, Nanubhai Jhaveri case made, there was no question of using the word Larsen. And therefore, court has given the judgment. But fortunately, we have reviewed his all documents, evidence, and we found that Larsen Engineers, so Larsen and Toubro, because see, therefore you need to understand, being a Larsen and Toubro, it's a big company, some 1,000 crores of the turnover, many divisions. So one of the division has given 3 or 4 contracts to Larsen Engineers only, some fabrication job. So we have taken a stand when Larsen and Toubro themselves have given the orders to Larsen Engineers, and they never confused. There is a question that common person will get confused. So on the basis of that, the court has vacated the injunction, but the whole objective of what is the name of why I have kept the Larsen, that was there. Then the case has prolonged because of the damages and everything. And at the age of 74, Nanubhai Jhaveri died, unfortunately. So case got closed. Then there were no legal heirs. So you have to be very careful about the use of the name, why you are using the name while selecting the name. And therefore, never use any personal name, the name of the God. No. Design your own name.
Okay, so any other question? there are no further questions. So I request Dr. Meena Bankar. Dr. Meena Bankar, madam, who is the additional vice principal of college, to propose a vote of thanks. Madam, can you hear me?
Yes, yes, Ashok sir.
Yes. Please go ahead. Vote of thanks.
Okay, sir. Thank you. Good afternoon, everyone. Sir, I'm audible. You can hear
yes,
me
clearly. Yes, madam. Yes, madam.
All right. On behalf of Lala Lajpat Rai College, I take this opportunity to thank all of you who are instrumental in holding and listening this very, very important webinar on intellectual property right. First of all, I would like to express my deepest gratitude and thanks to our team of management of Lala Lajpat Rai College, Principal Madam, Vice Principal Madam, as well as co-curricular activities cell organizers. However, my deepest gratitude and heartfelt thanks are due to our speaker, Advocate Shailendra Thatte, sir. Sir, thank you that you have accepted our invitation and you have spoken about basics of IPR. You have elaborated very well for intellectual property right areas, trademarks, copyrights, patents, designs. Thank you so much, sir, that you have shared your expertise with us with practical cases and practical examples. Intellectual people like you should go ahead and have social awareness about intellectual property right. I felt we were very fortunate to listen to you, sir, and we would like to listen to you again and again. Usually we are used to theoretical work and theoretical concepts and theories, but your practical session was so enlightening that I feel like doing another PhD on intellectual property rights. So thank you very much for being with us. Now, I would like to thank all participants, faculties and students of various colleges as well as our colleges that you spared your time and you attended this webinar of IPR. Lastly, a great thank you to Ashok Mahadik, sir, Dr. Ashok Mahadik, who is a member of our co-curricular activities cell and a member of Department of Accounts. So thank you very much. With your IT team, Vishakha, Jyoti, as well as with my colleague Divya and IQSC coordinator Vinay, sir, you have arranged this webinar very well. Thank you, everyone. Thank you. And I hope that you all attend our next session on gender violence, which is on 8th September also. Sir, Thatte sir, even you and your team is invited for the same. We would be glad if you be a part of us, you would be associated with us for a longer time. We would like to see you as a guest lecturer because you are the best teacher. I'm sure the students who have attended this seminar, this webinar, have gained a lot. I had requested my TY BCom student, I had requested my SY BCom students, and the students joined it, and I'm sure they have gained a lot. Whatever they have gained would be helpful to them in the future. And therefore, we would like to have an expert like you, intellectual person like you, associated with us for the long term. Hello. Thank you. Thank you very much.
My pleasure. My pleasure. And thank you for inviting me.
Thank you, madam. And once again, thank you so much, Advocate Shailendra Thatte, sir. Thank you so much. So, sir, you can leave the meeting because I have to keep the meeting